the boy with the gray hair?
That's my grandfather. That's also him. There he is again, a soldier. And yeah, that's him again, looking pretty sharp. There he is, walking stick and a beard, basically how I remember him. Except that photo was probably taken around the same time as this one. He was an actor, you see, and he could change his face to suit whatever story was being told. Reading his letters revealed a lot about his early acting career. His love of stories. His talents with makeup. There's plenty in there about his regrets and his failed ambitions as well.
You know, we all of us want that which we cannot have.
Michael sacrificed his acting career when he moved to a non-English speaking country. So because of all the violence and racism during apartheid, Michael decided that Johannesburg was no longer safe. So he took his family and moved to Israel.
For these people live on a battlefield. Their children go to school through no man's land. They ride to work amid the whine of enemy snipers' bullets.
In 2005, he moved to Sydney, Australia. Now in an English-speaking country, he rediscovered his acting career.
While she's in the bath, one case. With her boyfriend, five cases.
His writing is also full of joy and happiness about his family and his accomplishments, and there's plenty of humor as well. He was clearly excited to be back in business. That's me in the crowd there. I think I took after my grandfather in more ways than I even considered. Growing up around such a character, hearing his songs, seeing his drawings, watching him on TV and in his plays, it left its mark on me. It inspired me and my love of stories and characters. Even in his final years, Michael never lost that flair.
Yeah, and hip, 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 hooray. For I'm a jolly good fellow, I'm 93 today.
He always had his humour and his attitude. He never lost that passion for the story.
My job is the very air that I breathe.
Without him, I don't think I'd be where I am today.